Today, we will create a dashboard without importing data from an external source. We will use the Enter Data feature of the Power BI desktop, and we will enter data directly into the Power BI desktop and use that data to create a dashboard. Welcome to another Power BI tutorial. Today we will use the enter data to directly enter the data into Power BI desktop. That means we will not use the get data feature to import data from an external source. Rather, we will enter data directly into the Power BI desktop through this window. In this create table window, here we can enter the name of the table, and here we can enter data in columns and rows just like Microsoft Excel. So let's start with entering the data. Let's say we are XYZ Corp and we have two stores, East and West, with 3 months of sales data. In the next column, we will enter the month number, and in the last column, we will enter the amount of sales. So let's say we have 1, 2, and 3 months, and we will copy the West on the fourth row and East on the first three rows. Then we will continue the sequence 1, 2, and 3 and copy the West to the fifth and sixth row. We will just enter some random values in the sales column. So our data is now ready, and at this point, you can either click on the load button or the edit button. The load button will directly load this data into the Power BI desktop, while the edit button will take you to the Power Query window, where you can further perform analysis or processing on this data. It is always better to go to the Power Query, where you can review the data before loading this into the Power BI desktop. So if everything is fine here and you do not want to make any changes to the data, you can just click on the close and apply button, and the data will load into the Power BI desktop. Once the data is loaded, all the tables and their fields will appear here, which you can use to create dashboards. We will start our dashboard by adding a title to our dashboard using a text box visual. From this window, we can change the font and font size. We will keep the same font. However, we will change the font size to 32, and we will adjust the width and the height of the title text box like this. That's it. And now we will also change it to bold. Next, let's add a visual from this area. We will add a pie chart to our dashboard. We will adjust it by using our mouse. We will add the month, store to the legend, and the sales to the values area. and we will remove this sum of from sales, and that's it. This is our sales chart. From this pie chart, we can compare the sales of both stores, and we can clearly see that the West store has more sales, 57.78% as compared to the 42.2% of the sales from East store. Let's add another pie chart and see in which month we had more sales. So we will add the month to the legend area and the sales to the values area. Again, we will remove this extra text, and these are our sales in 3 months, and we have about the same sales during all 3 months. In third month, we had a slightly more sales, 35.56 as compared to 33% and 31%. Here we have compared the sales of both stores in total. However, we can also compare their sales over 3 months, and for that we will add a line chart where both lines will represent their sales over 3 months. Here we will add the month field to the x-axis, the sales field to the y-axis, and the store field to the legend area. And now we can easily compare sales of both stores over 3 months, and we can say that in the first month, sales of East store were higher as compared to the West store, but in the next 2 months, the West store went ahead in terms of sale. We will also remove the extra text from the sales field. Although this chart shows us monthly sales of both stores, however, this chart does not show us the total sales of entire company in 3 months. So let's add another line chart here, and this line chart will show us the sales of entire company over 3 months in total, and we will add the month field to the x-axis and the sales field to the y-axis, and that's it. As usual, we will remove this from sales field, and here we can see that in January sales were higher, then they dropped in February, and in March they went even higher. So this is the end of our today's exercise, and good luck.